So in this video, we'll be adding the keylogger functionality to our C2 client. Before that, we'll be reviewing the Python keylogging code. So I have already written this one. So don't worry, we'll be writing again in our client. So we'll be using the module called pyinput. It does not come default with the Python packages. You need to install it from pip install pyinput. So this should do fine. We'll be installing this module on the victim machine if pyinput is not there. So we can install it using we can send the command pip install pyinput from our server, and the client will get that command executed, and we'll be installing pyinput. So after installation, we need to import the key and listener from the keyboard. There is the listener function, and this listener function goes on listening, and whenever there is an event that is like a key presser, if you press any key on the keyboard, the function corresponding to this on press gets executed, and when you release the key, the function corresponding to this on release gets executed. So whenever I press the key, we can see here the key is, the variable is passed in the pressed function, and this key can be you can write it into the flag.txt, or you can just append this into any rest. So let's go and run this, and now you can see this is multi-threading. Generally, if you write a single program over this keylogger, you need to use the l.join, but here we'll be using we'll be creating a thread for this keylog function, and it will be starting for the keylogs. And here you can see in the background, let's go and open Notepad and let's say hello world. The thread logs all these keystrokes, and at the same time you can see here the main thread is waiting for the user input. Let's say quit. Whenever I say quit, and here you can see all of the keys I have printed, including from opening the Notepad. So you can see this is a very nice threaded keylogger. So we'll be implementing this one. So we need to import in the client. So first we need to decide which commands will activate the keylogger. So what we are going to do is, we are going to say elif command input of thread index, that is the input given in the web interface, is equals to let's say keylog on. So this should start the keylogger on the client. So we will be sending this. So we need to send this to our client, connection.sendoff, command.encode. And in the client side, let's go and code the keylogger. So before that, we will be copying the entire message to this full message variable before we are going to split the command. So the full message contains keylog on. And we can write a normal elif message of 0 is equals to keylog on. So that means we have received the command from the server stating that I should start the keylogger. So we can say t1 is equals to threading dot thread of target is equals to, let's say, keylog, and we can say t1 dot start. So we need to define the function that is keylog. Define keylog, and here we can say l is equals to listener of on press. Whenever the user presses any key, we need to execute a function pressed and on release released, and we can say l dot start. So the listener gets started. We need to define another two functions, those are pressed and released. So what action we need to perform whenever the key is pressed? Pressed of key. So we can say we can define in rest here keys. Let's say all keys, and we should declare this as global and global all keys. Now what we can do is all keys dot append of string of key. So we need to convert this one into string, and we are appending to the list. And another function released of key. So we are not writing anything in this function, we can just say pass. So the thread has been started. Now what we can do is we can send a message is equals to key logging has started, something like this. So we can say send off message dot encode. Now this message should be received by our client side, and you can say message is equals to connection dot receive of 2048 bytes dot decode. So we have received the message, and we now we should say command output of thread index. So we are updating the output is equals to message. So this will be showing in the web interface. So that is about this key logon. Now after updating the message, we need to make the input as a empty string. So let's go and do this. I forgot that one. Now we need to write another function, that is another code, that is if the input is key log off. So that means we are stopping the key logger, and this time we will receive the output of all the keys typed by the user. So we can say, we can copy this one, connection dot send off cmd dot encode. So after sending the key log off, we need to write another code. So after sending this, we need to again go into the receiving mode. Now we have received the key log off command from the server. Now this time we need to stop this thread, and we need to send the output of this list. So let's go and do this. Now to stop the thread, you can simply say t1.join. So this should stop the thread, and we will get all the we will get the list, let's say global all keys. And we can say cs.sendoff all keys.encode. And after sending that, we need to go on again and receiving mode. Now we can just simply copy this one, just receiving the message and updating this command output of thread index. So let's go and run this one. Now let's say keyrog on. So we got the error. So threading is not defined. Sorry for that. Now let's go and type some words. This object has no attribute and code. Okay, what we are going to do is we are going to make this as a string. And all keys is equals to we are appending the string. Now after sending the message we need to all keys is equals to empty string. So it's like flushing all the stored keys. And now you can see we got the keys. Now let's also try again keyrog on. And now you can see we get the only latest typed keys. And we can see there are some letters, those are repeating. So let's go and fix that. I don't know why they are repeating. So it's so weird, why, I don't know why we are getting the repeated ones. So let's stop the server. Let's say global T1. Let's go and run this. So okay, I have successfully fixed the problem. So the problem is here. So whenever the thread is starting, simply t1.join is not closing the thread because there is already one listener that has been started. We need to stop the listener before stopping our thread. So that's why the simple modification is put this l.stop. So this should do fine. So let's go and run our server. And let's go and say keylogon, and now let's say abcd and then keylog off, and you can see abcd. Now let's go and run the keylogon again. Now this time the previous thread has been successfully stopped, and now if you submit this, and you can see we only get this one time Spider-Man. So that's how you do the multi-threaded keylogger. You can also put something like this, keylogging underscore mode. So this is just simply a flag. It indicates whether we are in the keylogging mode or not. Suppose if you type keylog off without typing the keylog on first, then you may get some errors. So that's why to avoid those errors, we'll be using this flag keylogging underscore mode. Now what we're going to do is whenever we are starting this keylogon, we are going to say that keylogging mode is equals to 1. So that means the keylogging mode has been started, and we can say if keylogging mode is equals to 1, then only we are going to stop this. That means this indicates that there is a thread running the pyinput listener, and we can stop that, and we can also stop the thread. If keylogging mode is equals to 0, so that means there is no thread listening for the keystrokes, then what we can do is we can say message keylogging should be started first. So this should be the message. So we can send that to the server, and we can receive for a next command. Now let's go and run this one. Now let's execute keylog off first. And if you submit this, you should get the keylogging should be started first. Okay, we got some errors. I'm sorry, we need to change this one. We are not sending all keys, we are sending message. Sorry for that. So we need to observe what we are copying and pasting. And you should see keylogging should be started first. Keylog on. And keylog off. And you can see the output. And again keylog on. Now this time let's say ABCD, and we should get only the single instances of each letter. Yes, you can see we got the ABCD. So this is how you do the multi-threaded keylogger. You can also do this one, pip install py input. This should work fine. Okay, we got some error. And we should see, so it took some time the pip install, so that's why the time.sleep is very low, and in this meantime the client is executing the pip install and we are directly asking for the this required index, so that's why we got the error. Now if you want to execute some commands that take some time, so we need to increase this time.sleep, otherwise for normal commands this should do fine.